Alright guys, so this new guide that I'm doing basically is focused around boss mechanics, not the whole raid in general, just on the bosses. Because to be honest, you get through the raids pretty quickly and you get to one boss and they normally keep you stumped for a while. So this last boss is the first one I'm starting with, Captain Blackheart in Blackheart Caverns. And he starts off with a pretty normal, straightforward boss, you know, tank does his job, healer does it, and DPSs just go in. But he has a few little surprises he likes to throw in towards, you know, well, pretty much whenever he feels like it. So the first one starts with this, it's a morph he does to you, turns into a skeleton, strips you of all your power, and all you have is just a normal basic attack. So what I normally do is I normally just spend my time killing the skeleton adds that spawn from the water. It's just keeping down the adds so the other DPS can still focus damage on the boss. And to be fair, you kind of kill these skeletons quickly anyway. Because what you find is when you don't do that, there tends to be a buildup of these adds, and they sometimes will hurt you a lot more than the actual boss. So that transformation takes about 30 seconds, and once it's done, you can only, you know, nominate another person. Pray it's not the healer or the tank, because that's when things get really dicey. And that's all it is, you do some more damage on him. He has a AoE kick, it's like a whirlwind AoE roundhouse. And depending on how you build yourself and how your character is spec'd, it can one-shot you, so it's just something to be mindful of if you're a close-range melee DPS. For a tank, that's no problem, you know, you're built to be stand close and do shit like that, so it's not a problem. But yeah, once you're looking out for those things, you want to keep them adds, you know, at a good amount. I think one time it could be up to 20 adds, even more, and they will hurt you a lot more than the boss will. And just watch out, there's that whirlwind kick. You know, if you're not looking out for that kick, you know, I mean, in your close range, that could, you know, hurt the group a lot, having to pick you up and there's ad shooting at them and all that. So it's just, and if the boss decides to morph the healer into a skeleton or the tank, you know, then it's a crisis about to happen there. So it's just something to be mindful of. But I think that's about it, really, when you look at it straightforwardly. You know, that's all you really have to pay attention to. Who gets morphed, you know, just watch out for the AoE kick, you know, keep the adds down to a minimum, and then just keep that damage on the boss constant as much as you can. Thanks for watching, guys, and look forward to my next video.